Hi guys, and welcome back to Barbie Dolls of the Week. This week I want to show you some different things, and hey, it's Easter, so for those who celebrate Easter, have a great holiday. And also, of course, it's still spring. It's going to be spring for a few months, but so far here it really hasn't seemed like spring. Last Sunday we had like 10 inches of snow, which was awful. But at least it melted the next day. It all melted, but we've had a lot of rain, so we're having a little bit of flooding issues now, and we're supposed to have possibly 1 to 3 inches more of snow tonight. So spring needs to get its act in gear. But anyway, I wanted to show you a few things today that are of interest that I came across when I was doing some just kind of sorting and going through things. So a few odds and ends before I show you a couple dolls. So I found this that I don't remember where I got this. It might have been a Barbie collector, something they sent out for people who were in the fan club at the time. So I thought that was kind of cool. On the, it's just a like a card or postcard, and it's got some information on the back about Barbie collector. And of course the website at the time, Barbie Basics. This is model number 5. Collection 001, and illustration by Bill Greening. So thank you, Bill, for that beautiful doll. I don't happen to have this one, and I know she's not quite this thin, but anyway, I thought this was a really cool illustration, and again, not sure where I got it, but maybe that was it. Okay, and I think I've shown you guys this before, but this was certainly worth showing again. This is some of these press-up stickers from Pen Art Productions. It was sold at a place called Benny's for 59 cents back in, looks like, 81, 82. It's dated 81, so. But it's got some cool, you know, Western fun Barbie and Ken, and maybe this is Golden Dream. I can't tell, but obviously she has a different dress on. It actually doesn't look like her in the face, but I'm not sure. And then here's, I believe, Prince the dog. And it's got a Superstar Ken and Barbie up here with the Barbie logo in a couple places. So, really cool. And it does say, distributed by Gordy International. And Barbie is, of course, a trademark of Mattel. So, I wanted to show you that. And then, look what I came across that I'd forgotten that I have. This is so beautiful. This is a big coloring book by Golden Books for Loving You Barbie. It was originally at 99 cents according to the price here. Of course, this was sold at Osco, a drugstore we don't have anymore that used to be here. And Barbie and Loving You, it says our trademarks, of course. It says, enhance your child's learning right at home with Golden Step Ahead books, flashcards, etc. developed by educators. This helps with children helps children stay ahead, a step ahead. Look for Golden Step and other... Well, this isn't even about Barbie, so never mind that. But isn't that a beautiful picture of her? She's got very rosy cheeks. And then inside, of course, it's a coloring book, so, and none of it was colored yet, but it's got such wonderful illustrations. And talking about the boutique and, you know, oh my gosh, here she is shooting a gun, but it's just a fake one. At the ducks at the carnival, the little fake ducks. And here's her with, I assume, Ken, and they won a lion, pet lion, fake, of course. And just all kinds of other stuff. This is so cool. I mean, the pictures in here are worth a lot. I don't know. They're just amazing. And, like, here's somebody. I don't know who this is supposed to be. But the big boom box there. So, yeah, these are just amazing illustrations, and I don't think, let me see if it says anywhere who did the illustrations exactly, if I can get that open. Let's see. Da, 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 da. No part of this book may be reproduced or copied, huh, without written permission from the publisher. But, you know, I don't see anything about who did the illustrations, so that's unfortunate, but, oh, look, here they are on a Ferris wheel. That's so, I just think this is so cool. I think I got this at a flea market or fairground, at our fairground. So, Okay, and then look at this that I found. I knew I had this, but I'd forgotten about it. This is a Barbie month-by-month calendar for 1991. See what's new and exciting in the world of Barbie. So, of course, you got a lot of people on the cover, and then each month is talking about a different, doll. Like, for instance, actually, they go to March of '92, and they have Dolls of the World that you see there. And I'm sure you guys recognize some of them. In October of '91, they have Fashions by the Private Collection. Fashions. And then let's just see what else is in here. For February, they have the Hawaiian Fun doll set with the play sets. Some play sets. January, by the way, is a Happy Birthday Barbie from that year. Not my favorite. And then April is Lights and Lace. So I guess all these dolls came out that year. Here's August, which is Bath Time Fun. And it has that bath set with it. Let's see what else. In July, it's the All American group with the Jeep. So lots of nice dolls that came out that year are featured in this calendar. Let me just see if there are any others worth mentioning. I'm sure there is, but I don't want to go through every one of them. Let me just see who's in September. Oh, that's the ones. I do like this one. This is the Costume Ball Fashions. Some really cool, fun fashions in that set. So if you haven't seen them, let me just see October and December and we'll finish up. Oh yeah, I gotta show you December. It's the Christmassy one. So November is the another Ice Capade style. Nothing too exciting there. But look at December. Boy, I wished I had that under my Christmas tree or under any tree and I'd go get it. It's just such a cool house, the Barbie Magical Mansion. Wish I had gotten that. It's the only one that's out there that I would love to have, and I don't, as far as the houses. So, okay, now I want to show you a couple dolls that I got recently, starting with this one. This is the Teen Talk Barbie from '92, I think this was. Or sorry, '91. Well, out in '92. So she's got very large hair, as they did a lot back then. I like that strawberry, kind of a strawberry blonde, and it's a very festive outfit. Lots of colors. It reminds me of Blossom, if you remember the TV show Blossom, the way they dressed on that. That was just the time period. Now, on the back, and this box is kind of dinged up, but I want to show you the four dolls that are on here. So there's this crimped hair blonde one, there's the dark haired Teresa type one. The other blonde one that's more of just a Barbie, and then the one that I have here, which I think it's like a Midge, although it doesn't say, so I guess they're considering them all Barbie, and I'd be surprised if they didn't have an African American one, but it's not pictured here. But anyway, she's supposed to talk. I don't know that this one would still talk after all these years, probably not. She would need batteries or something. As you see, I got her for $10. At a local toy store around here. Rebecca Reinhardt, thanks for the tip again. I did get a few dolls from the Toy Pit in Fishers, Indiana. So, went up there this week and just found a few things, but this was one of them. And I think she's a really pretty doll. A lot of hair that could use a bit tamed, but and let's see what it says. It says, press the button on the back, her back, and she talks. Your doll is special. Teen Talk Barbie dolls have so many different surprise sayings. Each one has four fun phrases about school, shopping, parties, and activities, and here are just a few examples above. Choose your Barbie from a variety of dolls with different hairstyles, costume colors, and eye colors. Her outfit can change looks. So, yeah, I think they are all supposed to be Barbie versus Midge or Teresa, but anyway, this is the one that they had that I decided to go ahead and get. So, what do you guys think of her? And do any of you have this one? Let me know if you know if there is an African American or an Asian in that group. One other doll for sure that I want to show you from that purchase from the Toy Pit this week is Emerald Elegance, which is a long time doll that was, I think this was big at Toys R Us. I don't know if it was at other stores too. I thought I was going to see something that said Toys R Us exclusive. Now, this one is from Toys R Us, but I don't see that on here, so maybe it wasn't. But I always thought this was a very pretty redhead doll. Didn't love the outfit. The outfit is okay. It certainly reminds me of, you know, she's a citizen of Emerald City. You know, very Emerald City, and would fit right in there. Maybe she's the guard's wife or something, because she's very festive. I do love that hair. I may go ahead and take her out of the box. I'm not sure yet. But if so, I'm going to try to do something with her hair besides what it is right now. Which is, of course, just flared out. And, you know. And on the back, it's obviously very billowed and styled and probably hairspray in it. So, but she's a really pretty doll, I think. And the last doll I want to show you today is just... I meant to show you guys this in the last video when I was talking about the fashionistas. But I did find this one at Walmart this week. Yeah, it was Walmart. And I had been looking for him. I don't particularly love this one, but I think it could end up being a hard-to-find one. And so I wanted to get it, and maybe I'll sell it later. I'll tell you, it is so pale. It's the palest Ken I think I've ever seen in my life. And I'm not sure if he's supposed to be what, you know, where he's supposed to be from as far as ethnicity. But yeah, very, very pale, Asian looking to me. He's one of the smaller guys, and I don't like that shirt really, but its shorts are okay. Now, here's the thing. You know who this reminds me of is Eddie Munster. In a way, it reminds me of Eddie Munster. Of course, Eddie didn't have the little man bun, but I mean, just if you take the man bun off, it does sort of remind me of Eddie. Of course, was supposed to be a little Dracula kind of kid, so it made sense that he was that pale. So anyway, I did want to get this. And now, by the way, the only two that I haven't gotten on the male dolls are this African-American one, which I probably will get, and this Ken, which I don't know that I'm going to get. I'm not sure. I'm not fond of that one too much. But anyway, I wanted to show you guys this as I wrap up for the week. And I hope you've enjoyed this extra video this week. Got two for the price of one, which is free, by the way. So enjoy your week, and I will see you next time. Bye.